Rectores magnifici, spectabiles, honorabiles, vaše excelence, vážené dámy a pánové, zahajuji slavnostní veřejné zasedání Vědecké rady Českého vysokého učení technického v Praze, kterému předsedá rektor a předseda Vědecké rady, docent dr. Vojtěch Petráček, kandidát věd, a na kterém vás všechny srdečně vítám. Na programu dnešního slavnostního zasedání Vědecké rady Českého vysokého učení technického v Praze je především zvlášť významný úkol udělení čestného titulu doktor honoris causa Českého vysokého učení technického v Praze profesoru Wolfgangovi Wallstrovi. Dále předání Felbrových medailí a předání cen rektora za rok 2018. Nyní přistoupíme k udělení čestného titulu doktor honoris causa Českého vysokého učení technického v Praze. Nejprve si dovoluji požádat ředitele Českého institutu informatiky, robotiky a kybernetiky doktora Velka, aby představil doktoranda profesora Wolfganga Wallstra.
Your Magnificence Rector Vojtěch Petráček, dear members of assembly, dear deputy minister and deputy prime minister and minister of industry and trade Karel Havlíček, your excellency the ambassador of Germany to Czech Mr. Christopher Isrank, dear Mr. Rudolf Jelínek from the president's office, and all other distinguished guests. I have been given the honor of presenting and justifying to today's ceremonial assembly the award of the honorary title Doctore Honoris Causa for Professor Wolfgang Wallstr. Wolfgang Wallstr is a professor and scientist in the field of computer science, especially artificial intelligence, and he is also scientific father of Industry 4.0. In our institute, we are having many visitors, or many of my friends are asking me, what does it mean, Industry 4.0? Okay, Industry 4.0, it can be some smart, flexible factory. Each product, each tool, each machine has some virtual twin. And but they are asking, okay, this technology, this everything is already existing. Robots are working in factory. We have Internet of Things. This is existing. Why is it called fourth revolution of industry? They understand first industrial revolution change from human handmade products to products made by machines empowered by power of steam and power of water. But what is so revolutionary on Industry 4.0? Why is it called revolution? I believe that all these tools, or this is just tools, and what is revolutionary for us, it will change our life. It will give us new products, new possibility to us and to our children. My very favorite example is, if I go to buy shoes, I always try two size. Sometimes I buy shoes 45, 46. But in near future, I will have a 3D model of my feet. And if I will need shoes, I will choose from any maker, and they will make shoes not in 1 million pieces somewhere far away place in China, but it will be made shoes exactly fitting size of my feet on my demand. And factory in the future, it will not be about building factory where is some written trademark at the door, but it will be about having this 3D model and this technology of shoes. So if I am traveling somewhere, for example, I arrive to Thailand and my luggage is missing, I will just open my notebook and I will send, I will choose my favorite shoes maker, I don't know, Adidas, Nike for sport shoes. I will send my 3D model of my feet, and I don't know if Adidas has a factory in Thailand, but I'm very sure there is some factory and they will send their model of their sport shoes plus my model of my feet, and they will make shoes for me. So I believe this is really something what will change our life in near future. And of course, Professor Wallster is not only one person who is involved in this Industry 4.0, but I am very sure there is no existing other person who can be more called godfather of these new ideas. Professor Wallström became professor in his age 29 years old, associated professor, and 2 years later he became full-time professor of computer science. And during his long academic life, he educated new generation of scientists. He supervised many PhD students. About 20 of them are already also established professors. However, I see the biggest, I would say, life assignment of Professor Wallster. It was founding the German Research Center for Artificial Intelligence in Saarbrücken in 1988. And he's leading this institute in position of scientific director and managing director for very long, 31 years. Under his leadership, the institute developed into the large research center for artificial intelligence, which is having more than 1,000 researchers and budget, annual budget, more than 50 million euro. His focus on excellence in research and on one side, and on the other side, his sense for cooperation with industry was very inspiring also for us, for Czech Institute of Informatic Robotics and Cybernetics, which was founded by Czech Technical University in 2013. Also, the prestige appointment of Professor Wallström was advisory for 2 German chancellors, Dr. Gerhard Schröder and Dr. Angela Merkel. He positively influenced many government programs in Germany for supporting research and technology and cooperation between academia and industry. Until now, I was talking about life work of Professor Wallström, but today we met here in this magnificent and historical chapel of Czech Technical University. So there must be a relation between us and Professor Wallström. Professor Wallström started cooperation with researchers, professor of Czech Technical University after Velvet Revolution. He was helping establish Czech researchers to enter to the Western research societies. But for me, it's easy to talk about more recent time. Industry 4.0 was first mentioned in 2011, and maybe 2013 it was already better defined at Hanover Fair. And Czech side was very influenced by these ideas, and already at the end of 2015, Czech government appointed Professor Mařík together with other authors to prepare a manual how to transfer Czech industry to these new technologies. And this team of authors prepare initiative for Industry 4.0, submitted already in February 2016, and Czech government was very fast, and already in August it was accepted like official initiative. So Czech initiative was very inspired by ideas of Professor Wallström. Of course, we brought many new ideas. Maybe our view is more wider, including not only industry, not only manufacturing, but also society 4.0, education 4.0, energetic 4.0. So I think we were good students of these ideas, and we were able to develop also something new. I already said big influence was this German Center for Artificial Intelligence, which inspired us in building our institute. We signed an agreement in 2016 between German Institute and our CIRC, Czech Technical University, in presence of German Chancellor Angela Merkel. She visited us August 2018, and Czech Prime Minister Sobotka. Our cooperation is growing. We are now successfully building together Czech Technical University as main coordinator, but with together a partner in Brno and 2 partners in Germany. We are now building some facility for smart manufacturing, European facility for smart manufacturing, project called RECIVE. And this everything is not the end. It's just beginning of our cooperation, which I believe will be useful for Czech Technical University and for all Czech Republic. So I think I said already enough, so maybe His Magnificence Rector can decide if a long, many years friend Professor Marie can start the ceremony of awarding Professor Wolfgang Waster. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Velek, for presenting the doctoral candidate. Now I ask Your Magnificence for permission to perform the graduation ceremony.
I've listened with great interest to your report, Mr. Director, and to your proposal that the honor title of Doctor Honoris Causa be awarded to Professor Wolfgang Waster. At today's ceremonial assembly of the Scientific Council of the Czech Technical University in Prague. Since the Scientific Council of the Czech Technical University in Prague at its meeting on December 17, 2019 expressed its agreement with this proposal, and since all legal and formal conditions have been satisfied, I give my agreement that this graduation ceremony be held.
Thank you, Magnificence, for giving your agreement. I ask his promoter, Professor Mařík, to conduct the graduation ceremony.
Dear Professor Wolfgang Waster, the Scientific Council of the Czech Technical University in Prague has decided to bestow upon you the honorary title of the Doctor Honoris Causa of the Czech Technical University in Prague. Dear Professor Waster, I request you solemnly to take the following oath. Prosím všechny přítomné, aby znění slibu vyslechli ve stoje. I promise on my word of honor and conscience that as a doctor honoris causa of the Czech Technical University in Prague, I shall in my activities promote the development of scientific and technical knowledge for the benefit of mankind. I shall follow ethical principles and shall contribute to the pursuit of the human ideals of a democratic society. Being conscious of the glorious tradition of this oldest Czech Technical University, I shall always promote the reputation of the Czech Technical University in Prague, and as opportunities arise, I shall support its educational, scientific, and other creative and artistic activities. Do you promise?
I promise.
Nothing now stands in the way of me awarding to you the honors that our university has bestowed on you as the duly designated promoter. I therefore pronounce you, dear Professor Wolfgang Waster, Doctor Honoris Causa of the Czech Technical University in Prague. In confirmation of this, I hand you a diploma, and for today's ceremonies, I loan to you a chain as a symbol of the permanent bond that will forever link you with our technical university. My request, congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
On behalf of the Scientific Council of the Czech Technical University in Prague, and in my own name, I congratulate Professor Wolfgang Walster, holder of the honorary title of Doctor Honoris Causa of the Czech Technical University in Prague. And I ask him on this occasion to deliver his address.
Thank you very much. Dear Rector Magnificus, Professor Petracek, dear Minister Havlicek, dear Ambassador, dear Professor Magik as a promoter and Dr. Velek as a laudator, dear members of the Scientific Council, Excellencies, Deans, dear colleagues and friends. I feel deeply honored by the decision of the Scientific Council of the Czech Technical University in Prague as one of the oldest and best technical universities in Europe to award me this prestigious honorary title, Doctor Honoris Causa. It gives me great joy and satisfaction that this award underlines the impact of artificial intelligence and Industry 4.0 on the Czech and German research about advanced manufacturing, as well as on the economy of both countries. The digitalization of industrial production, products and services plays a critical role for the future of both countries. The intensive collaboration of the two leading institutes in industrial artificial intelligence, namely CIRC and DFKI, ensures that both countries remain the globally leading suppliers for the next generation of smart factories. Research on Industry 4.0 combines many academic fields, such as cyber-physical systems, robotics, machine perception, Internet of Things, multi-agent systems, knowledge representation, automated detection, planning systems, multimodal dialogue systems, as well as data analytics and machine learning. I'm a great admirer of CIRC, since it brings together under one roof world-class scientists for all these component technologies in an ultra-modern building. For more than 30 years, Professor Mazik, Professor Hajicková and I organized the collaboration and the flow of information between both universities in Prague and DFKI, always as a two-way street, profiting both sides and in many cases with a worldwide impact. Artificial intelligence has the power to reshape the world, but we must make sure that we maintain the control over AI systems and that we prevent the misuse of AI. I'm happy that all colleagues here at my new alma mater, Honoris Causa, share my belief that our AI systems must be human-centric, that they should support humans, and that they are committed to pursue always our objectives and not theirs. Once again, I would like to thank the Czech Technical University very much for this distinction and for Dr. Velek's wonderful laudation. Listening to a laudation about yourself is always the most challenging part of such ceremonies. For a moment, you can consider yourself to be a saint until your family brings you back down to earth, since they know best all of your deficits. I'm the one standing here accepting this honor, but it belongs at least equally to the great teams that I have had the good fortune to work with at the various stages of my career. Dear Rector Magnificus, Professor Petracek, the enormous progress made by Czech industry over the past decade would have been unthinkable without your university. My cooperation with your university has always been based on my deep respect for the scientific excellence at CIRC and its partner faculties, the reliability of all Czech project partners and their very hard-working staff, as well as the shared socio-economic values and ethical principles. Thank you very much for your attention.
Dear Professor Walster, thank you very much for your speech. Nyní prosím pány hudebníky Františka Bílka a Michala Hanzala o přednes skladby pro solovou trubku a varhany. Dalším bodem dnešního programu je udělení Felbrových medailí prvního a druhého stupně. Felbrovy medaile se udělují jako podsta pracovníkům za významnou pedagogickou a vědeckou činnost ve prospěch Českého vysokého učení technického. Prosím pana rektora o předání medailí a vyznamenané, aby předstoupili před vědeckou radu a převzali z rukou pana rektora medaily a diplom. Felbrova medaile prvního stupně, zlatá, byla udělena inženýru architektorovi Johnovi Eislerovi AIA. Felberova medaile druhého stupně stříbrná byla udělena následujícím pracovníkům fakulty strojní. Profesoru inženýru Jiřímu Baštovi, doktorovi z Ústavu techniky prostředí fakulty strojní. Dále profesoru inženýru Jaroslavu Kvostovi, kandidátu věd, z Ústavu technické matematiky fakulty strojní, který se z dnešního zasedání omluvil. Dále profesoru inženýru Jaromírovi Houšovi, doktoru věd, z Ústavu výrobních strojů a zařízení fakulty strojní. Dále profesoru inženýrovi Františkovi Rigrovi, doktoru věd z Ústavu procesní a zpracovatelské techniky fakulty strojní. Dále profesoru inženýrovi Milanovi Růžičkovi, kandidátu věd z Ústavu mechaniky, biomechaniky a mechatroniky fakulty strojní. A dále profesoru inženýrovi Janovi Suchánkovi, kandidátu věd z Ústavu strojírenské technologie fakulty strojní. Děkuji, pane rektore. Posledním bodem dnešního programu je předání cen rektora za vynikající výsledky ve výzkumu za rok 2018. Prosím pana rektora o předání cen a zároveň oceněné o jejich převzetí. Na základě návrhu fakult udělil rektor Českého vysokého učení technického docent dr. Vojtěch Petráček, kandidát věd, cenu rektora za vynikající doktorskou práci inženýrce Jaroslavě Hrtánkové, doktorce, z Fakulty jaderné a fyzikálně inženýrské za práci Study of Antihadron Interactions with Nuclear Medium. Cenu rektora za vynikající vědecký výsledek udělil docentu inženýru Liborovi Šnoblovi, doktorovi z Fakulty jaderné a fyzikálně inženýrské, společně s Antonel Marchiesello, doktorkou z Fakulty informačních technologií, za práci superintegrabilní systémy v magnetických polích ve třech prostorových rozměrech. Cenu rektora za aplikaci výsledku výzkumné práce v praxi obdrželi profesor inženýr Daniel Sikora, doktor, a inženýr Ondřej Jamryška z Fakulty elektrotechnické za prodej licencí patentu GridCut. Prosím o převzetí ceny pana inženýra Jamryšku. Cena rektora za prestižní publikaci byla udělena profesoru akademickému architektu Mikulášovi Hulcovi a kolektivu z Fakulty stavební za publikaci Sbory církve československé husitské architektonické dědictví našich regionů. Prosím zástupce kolektivu, docentku Popelovou a inženýra Brankova o převzetí ceny. Stejnou cenu za vynikající prestižní publikaci udělil profesoru inženýru Janu Sikorovi, kandidátovi věd, z Fakulty elektrotechnické za Wireless Physical Layer Network Coding. Za knihu tedy. Prosím o převzetí ceny. Vážený pane rektore, děkuji za předání cen. Vážené dámy a pánové, vážení hosté, tímto významným aktem, kterým bylo udělení čestného titulu doktor honoris causa Českého vysokého učení technického, udělení Felbrových medailí a cen rektora, se dnešní program slavnostního zasedání Vědecké rady naplnil. Dovolte mi, abych poděkoval vám, našim milým a vzácným hostům, za to, že jste nás poctili svojí účastí. Dnešní veřejné slavnostní zasedání Vědecké rady Českého vysokého učení technického v Praze tímto prohlašuji za ukončené.